Welcome to the office of the Westchester County Clerk's Westchester Records Online, or WRO, tutorial series. And welcome on behalf of Westchester County Clerk, Tim Idoni. This tutorial will demonstrate how to view images of documents as a registered user in Westchester Records Online, including creating a registered user account, renewing a registered user subscription, and troubleshooting common login and image viewing issues. To begin, navigate to Westchester Records Online at wro.westchesterclerk.com. On the login screen, you will find three large buttons to allow you to immediately enter the system and search land records, legal records, or maps as a guest. Or you can enter your user ID and password to enter as a registered user, which will allow you to open, view, print, and save documents. If we enter WRO as a guest and conduct a search, you will see that the icons for the images of documents are gray and do not open. We encourage users to search for documents as a guest to verify that the desired documents are available prior to paying for a registered user subscription. If the document you are looking for doesn't have a gray image icon, then there is not an image available for that document, even if you purchase a subscription to view images. If the document you are looking for has an icon, but there's a padlock on the icon, that indicates that the document is sealed or for other reasons blocked from online viewing, even with a registered user subscription. We also encourage users to review the system requirements prior to purchasing a registered user subscription. While we make every effort to make WRO compatible across browsers, the county IT does not support Macintosh, and so Mac users may encounter difficulties navigating the system and displaying images. To view the images of documents, you must create a registered user account and choose a subscription level, depending on how much you intend to use WRO. We offer two subscription levels, a one-day subscription for $20, which ends at midnight of the following day, or a year-long subscription for $1,200, which ends 365 days from the current day. If you haven't created an account before, just click the link above the login fields to create a registered user account. On the Create an Account page, you will need to enter your name and email address and then choose a user ID and password. Please make sure that your password is at least 8 characters long and contains at least one letter and one number. When you click Continue, the system will make sure you entered all the required information, it'll make sure your password conforms to the security rules, and it'll verify that you haven't previously created an account by checking to see if your email address is already in the system. On the next screen, you can choose the subscription you'd like to add to your account. The top two options will allow you to view images of documents for a day or for a year. Below that, you will see options to buy foreclosure reports, business certificate reports, and judgment and liens reports. The reports can be purchased for a single week's worth of transactions or for the entire year. You can click the information icon next to the weekly or yearly reports to learn more about those subscriptions. We'll click on the first option at the top to add a daily subscription for $20. Keep in mind that the daily subscription ends at midnight of the following day, so if you subscribe in the morning, you will have access to images that entire day and the following day. Any subscriptions you choose will be reflected in the shopping cart to the right. If you add a subscription and then decide that you do not want that option, you can click the DEL to the left of the item in the shopping cart to remove it. Once you have chosen your subscription or subscriptions, click Continue to proceed to the payment screen. On the payment screen, you will be asked for additional contact information and then credit card information to pay for the subscription. If the credit card you intend to use has the same name and address as you entered in the General Details section, you can simply check the box to copy the information to the Credit Card Details section. Please make sure that you enter the information that is associated with the credit card in the section for the credit card details. It may seem obvious, but it's quite common that a customer will put down their personal information but use a business credit card with different information. Finally, enter the type of credit card, the credit card number, expiration date, and the authorization code from the front or back of the credit card, then check the box to agree to the terms of service and click Continue. The next screen will give you the opportunity to review all the information you've entered and the subscription you have chosen, as well as the total price before charging the credit card. If you need to make any changes, click Back in the lower right corner. Otherwise, click Continue and the transaction will be processed and you will be provided with a confirmation receipt on the next screen. If you would like to print a copy of the confirmation receipt, click the Print button below the total and WRO will format the screen for printing and provide a print dialog box to send the receipt to the printer. You can now click Login to start searching to return to the login screen, where you can enter your user ID and password to enter the system as a registered user with the ability to view, save, and print document images. Once we enter the username and password that we just created, we'll be logged into WRO and find ourselves on the Land Records tab. When logged in as a registered user, WRO is essentially identical to the way the system appears to a guest, with a few small differences. You'll notice in the upper right-hand corner that your name is now displayed, along with the expiration date of your image subscription, or else the word expired if your image subscription has expired. You will also find the button to log out and a button to renew your image subscription or purchase reports. There are two additional tabs available to registered users, the Reports tab and the Settings tab. If you've purchased a subscription to view foreclosure, business filings, or judgments and liens reports, they can be accessed by clicking on the Reports tab. You can click the Settings tab to change the details you entered when creating your account, to change your password, or to change which section of WRO you enter upon logging in. To change the contact details associated with your account, click Settings, make any changes in the fields on the right, then click Save Contact Details. To change your password, click Change Password, enter your current password, enter your new password, and then confirm the password by typing it again, and then click Save New Password. Below the Change Password section, you can choose which tab and subtab you arrive at when you log into your account. An attorney might want to set the system to start in the Legal Records section, while a title searcher might prefer to start in the Land Records section, and a user who subscribes to reports might prefer to start at the Reports tab when he or she logs in. After choosing your preferred tab to start at, click Save Preferences to save your choice. Below the Preferences field, you will see any image or reports subscriptions you have purchased and their expiration dates, as well as a link to purchase or renew a subscription. The settings that you have entered on this tab remain each time you log into your account, even if you previously had a subscription to view images which has expired. Your registered user account remains even when your subscription expires. If you return to WRO at a later date and want to purchase a new subscription to view images, you do not need to go through the registration process again to create a new account. Instead, just log in with your existing WRO account. If you don't remember your user ID or password, you can click one of the links below the login fields. Once you log into your registered user account, you will see your name in the upper right-hand corner, but underneath it will say your subscription is expired. To add additional time to your user account, simply click Renew in the upper right corner, and you'll be taken to the shopping cart screen, where you can choose an image subscription or purchase reports. I'll click on the $20 option to view images for the day until midnight of the following day. The payment process is exactly the same as it was when we initially created the account. For your security, you must enter your credit card information each time you renew, as we don't store credit card information, so there's no chance that a hacker could obtain our customers' payment information. Once you've gotten your payment receipt, you'll be returned to the login page, where you can now log back in with your subscription to view images renewed. Every now and then, a user may encounter difficulty logging in or viewing images. The most common help request we receive is to unlock a user account, and the most common reason for an account to become locked is because a user tried to log in with the wrong password too many times. If a user tries to log in with the incorrect password 5 times in a row, the account becomes locked. The account will automatically unlock itself after 20 minutes, Or you can click the Forgot Your Password link to reset your password, which will also unlock your account. A related issue is forgotten user IDs or passwords. If you've forgotten your password, you can click the Forgot Your Password link under the Login fields. You will then be prompted to enter your user ID and email, and then enter some funny-looking text to prove that you are a person and not a malicious program. When you enter the requested information and click Continue, an email will be sent to you with a link to reset your password. When you click the emailed link, you will be prompted to enter your new password and then to retype it to make sure that you typed it correctly the first time. You can then click the link to return to the login page and enter WRO using your new password. If you've forgotten your username, the process is virtually the same. Just click the Forgot Your User ID link under the login fields. You'll then be prompted to enter your email address and type the funny looking text to prove you are human, and then your user ID will be emailed to you. Another issue that users sometimes encounter when logging into WRO is the multiple session warning. If you try to log in with the user ID that is already logged in, WRO will alert you that the ID is already logged in, and it'll give you the option to end the existing session or to cancel. This warning gives the user discretion to either bump the other user off or to cancel until the user ID is free. If you click Yes, WRO will end the existing session and allow you to click Sign In and begin searching. We have received some inquiries from users who keep getting this message even though nobody else has access to the ID. There are a couple of reasons why this could happen. If you log into WRO and then close the window without logging out, the system thinks you are still logged in. After 20 minutes of inactivity, it will assume you are finished and it'll end your session. But if you close your WRO window without logging out and then try to log in again within 20 minutes, you'll get the message that the ID is logged into an active session, even though you don't think that you are currently logged in. You can simply click Yes in the pop-up and then click Sign In. Another reason a user might get this message is because he or she clicked Sign In multiple times. If the connection is slow, the system sometimes takes a little longer to log in, and some users click Sign In again and again, or else double-click the link, initiating two sessions. If you've clicked Sign In multiple times before the page loads, the system will think someone else is using your ID, and will display the multiple session pop-up. This can be especially frustrating for a user who clicks Yes to end the active session, only to get the same warning again and again when the user continues to click Sign In multiple times before it logs in. This can be avoided by just clicking Sign In a single time. Most browsers will have an indicator in the title bar that it is thinking and working on loading the site once you've clicked a link, so there's no need to click it a second time. With well over 20,000 searches conducted per day, the system can sometimes function a little more sluggishly in the middle of the day when most people are working and accessing the system, causing some users to think it's unresponsive when it's actually transferring the data to the browser. If you're logged in as a registered user and click on a yellow image icon and nothing happens, the most common reason is because of a pop-up blocker. Each browser is a little different in how they handle blocked pop-ups, but most give an indication in the address bar, often with a tiny red X that isn't terribly noticeable. By clicking on the X, it gives me options to continue blocking pop-ups, allow this pop-up, or always allow pop-ups from this site. It's recommended that you tell the browser to always allow pop-ups for WRO. After allowing pop-ups, you should be able to click the image icon and it'll open a new browser window as a PDF document. Thank you for joining us today for the WRO Registered Users tutorial video. Please visit us online and check out our other tutorials at westchesterclerk.com and visit our YouTube channel and Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. Thank you.